Alrighty. It's time for another stream. It is that time again for just yet another stream. I'm gonna turn on the game audio. There we go. And apparently we're gonna be playing it with the mod, somewhat. Somewhat, apparently. But yeah, where's my legitimate gamepad? There you are. Back to his eye screen. The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker HD. Alright. So I've been testing with it just a bit. But we're gonna make a new file anyway. There we go. Start the game. This is but one of the legends of which a people speak. Long ago, there existed a kingdom where a golden power lay hidden. There was a phosphorus land or something, But one day, a man of great evil found the great golden power and took it from himself. With its strength at his command, he spread darkness around the kingdom. But then, when all hope had died, and the hour of doom seemed at hand, a young boy, cloaked in green, appeared as if from nowhere. Wielding the blade of evil's bane, he sealed Dark One away and gave the land light. This boy who traveled through time to save the land was known as the Hero of Time. The boy's tale has passed down through generations until it became legend. But then, a day came when a fell wind began at the blow. The great evil that is all thought had been forever sealed away by the hero. Once again, crept forth from the depths of the earth, blah 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 blah. But people had believed that the hero of time would again come to save them. But the hero did not appear. Faced by an onslaught of evil, the people could do nothing but appeal to the gods. In their last hour, as doom drew nigh, they left their future in the hands of fate. What became of that kingdom? None remain who know. The memory of that kingdom vanished, but the legend survived on the wind's breath. On a certain island, it became customary to garb boys in green when they come of age. Clothed in the greens of fields, they aspired to find heroic blades and cast down evil. The elders wish only for the youths to know courage like the hero of legend. Hear me? I knew you'd be here. This is my favorite spot. I had to gaze out at the sea. When I play with the gulls, I call it a whale's lookout. So, do you remember what day it is today? You're still half asleep, aren't you? Like I am as well. I am still half asleep because I just woke up out of my fucking nap. Did you forget? Big Brother, it's your birthday. Been waiting for you to come back to the house. She's been waiting for a while. It's a good thing I came to find you. You should probably go home and see what Grandma wants, don't you think? Yep, of course. So, what's interesting about this game, it's been a hot minute since I last time played this game. Back in the GameCube day, I remember playing this game pretty much back in when did this game came out? Like 2003? I believe it's 2003. I remember getting this back in the GameCube, like around that time, unless it was like 2004. I remember playing this back when I was at a cousin's house or something, during my vacation, like at the summertime. And I always play this game all the fucking time when I bring my GameCube, with that little, portable, screen monitor or whatever. And let me bring up a screenshot. You know how it's like, God, I gotta bring up the monitor thing because, geez, that's like one of the things that I normally, back in the day, I always play Wind Waker and anything else with that fucking screen, that portable screen. That is the wrong image. Like, I always play with this son of a bitch right here. Like, this right here. It's always this fucking shit anyway. This little thing right here, like, I always play with this thing. I don't know why. It's so cool. Back in the day, like, I used to own this. And yeah, it was really cool back in the day. And when I got it, the cables literally got chewed off by a dog or something. I don't even know why. That was like back in the day, but that was like years later. But yeah, I used to play Wind Waker on my GameCube for that specific screen, and I still have my GameCube, and I still used to I used to have this game back then, and unfortunately, my other cousin stole it from me and literally sell it for like God knows how long, and I was fucking pissed. And literally, I cannot even get it back anywhere. So years later, until this game came out, this specific version, I was managed to get, because I had the Wii U like back in Christmas 2012. Like, this was at the time I was like, God, it was like nearly, it's almost 10 years old at that point. I had to get a Wii U, the deluxe edition. And then a year or so later, or somewhat a year later, this game came out. And I was completely shocked and completely excited when this was announced. Like, at the time, I remember playing this game so little time back in my childhood. It was like, I really need to play this game again. And that's when the HD version came out. Like, I literally completely played through this game entirety, again and again, like, throughout that time. And also, I used to watch a Let's Play video. I used to watch a Let's Play series of, shout outs to Sugar Conway, actually, to literally, showing a walkthrough of this game back in the day. Like, this was like 2010, 2011. This was like almost, around the time. YouTube was gonna get big, and also Let's Plays was getting big as well. And I seen like a lot of people Let's Play this game a lot throughout late 2000s to early 2010s. Because this game was so fucking good back in the day. And yeah, I still love this game, and this is the reason why that's pretty much why I'm streaming this game now. It's like, Jesus fucking Christ, this is the reason why now we're getting back to this game. Also, I literally forgot I need to, like, literally use the thing anyway. Don't you know to use my telescope? It's really easy to use, big brother. Press the plus button to set the telescope to set X and Y, X or R on the item select. Item select. Blah. Item screen. God, this is what happens when I wake up and woke up from a nap. Ben, you could use it just by pressing a button that you set it to. It's simple. And also, you're not going to be able to hear the gamepad because, Jesus fucking Christ, it will definitely, like, echo somewhat. So anyway, we're going to look at this bird right here. Buster right now looks kind of weird, doesn't he? Ah, Jigger, look at the sky! Pirates. Man, that was a direct hit. That was a complete direct hit. Jacobs, this is terrible. That girl fell into the forest. She needs help. But it's too dangerous for you to go in there without something you can use to defend yourself with. And that's why we need to go get ourselves a sword. And also, I gotta save because, Jesus fucking Christ, I don't want to go back in the process of doing this again. And here's what the reason why I cannot get the mod working. Which you'll see pretty much why. So, the reason why I wasn't able to get this mod working is because... Hi, old man. I'm not going to be able to talk to you right now. Which I'm already going to clip this anyway. So, the reason why I wasn't able to get this mod to work, this recolor right here, is because if I enter here, it crashes the game. So, we're just gonna quickly, I'm gonna quickly go to my graphics packs, which I'm gonna play just in TeamU anyway, because I would play this on the actual Wii U. But I'm playing this on CMU anyway, because this is just like literally the only fucking way for me to do so. As I sadly cannot do anything about it. So, sadly we will not be able to get the mod working. So, I will tweet this. And if somebody can give me an answer of why that crash, as I clip this. If someone can please explain to me why that crash, I really appreciate the help. Of why did it fucking crash? I don't know why it crashed. For some fucking reason, I don't know why. Because I might just make a tweet about it later. Just make a tweet about it later and see what I can do about it. But for now, we're going to be sticking with a default link. Just for the time being, is because of the fact that I can't get the mod working. I don't know why it just stopped working.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, you know what? I need to talk to this old man. That's the reason why. So soon? My. If you aren't already old enough to be wearing these clothes, then it's going to be very important for you to gather as much wisdom as you can from now on. If you're just making your way in the world, that is, Jacob. Now then, I'll be studying a wealth of topics since long before you were born. I'm what you call a brain of all trades. Get it? Da-ding. A brain of all trade. You're a smart little fellow yourself, aren't you? I've been thinking it's time for me to pass some of my wisdom down. And maybe you're the one I could pass it down to. Pass down to? Excuse me, I thought I was gonna hear, you know, the one downstairs. But I described everything you see, as you see tech towards it. Here's something I've been researched thoroughly. And before you ask, yes, I do know my filing system. My filing system is odd. Organizational issues aside, however, it's well extremely useful information. You would do well to read it all very carefully. Reading leads to knowing, you know? Such a racket! Can you keep it quiet? You've knocked everything off my shelves, you drat hooligan! Honestly, that hooligan, I'm referring to is my younger and much less intelligent brother, who lives just downstairs. He hates studying all day, every day, 24/7. Just exercises and practices with his weapons. Does he exercise with his brain? No! The brain's a muscle too, I think. Anyway, the only thing he does study is the art of fighting. Right now, for instance, he's been studying fences and whatnot. As if that's of any use to anyone. He simply doesn't know how to do anything besides exercise, I ask you. What's a butter to do? What's a butter to do, you know? Ho ho ho. See you later, Jacob. Anyway, I think now we can able to talk to him. He was like literally just standing here. Unless I had to talk to... You know what? I have to talk to my grandmother. That's what it is. That's what it is. For the flag. I have to trigger the flag. Literally, this is how you do it in game design. In a Zelda game. I have to do this.
Oh, Jacob, what's the matter? What's happened?
So what am I gonna do here anyway? Because I need to get a fucking sword. I can't do shit without a sword, you know? There we go. Actually, I need to talk to you again.
What say you, Jacob?
Ah! Have you come for some serious instruction in the way of a sword? Yes.
Very good. Your first lesson shall be the horizontal slice. Please may impress B.
Do not fear for my safety. I am ready for you.
Just press neutral B, dammit! Good. Keep going. Keep coming at me until you hear me say very good. Very good. Now for the vertical slice. Hold ZO to target me. Then press B. Keep swinging. Very good. Now for the thrust. Target with the ZL and tilt the left stick forward and press B. Come at me. Thrust your sword. Keep thrusting. Now for the spin attack. Hold B briefly to build up your strength. Then release it. Or rotate once and press B. More. Very good. Keep swinging. Next one's harder. This is a parry attack. Target with the ZL and use with a sparkling A. And then quickly press A again to perform a defensive strike. Very good. And again, target me again. And now for the jump attack. Such a fine display. And yet I sense a certain exhaustiveness. Exactness. Excuse me for my vocabulary, actually, or my grammar. In the sword you hold, an eagerness that goes far beyond the mere desire to be wielded on the fields of battle. I do not know what has happened, but I have faith in you. Somehow I doubt you will misuse that sword. You may have it, Jacob. I give it freely. Take the blade with you. You accepted the hero's sword. Use it wisely and carefully. You don't want to let down this kind old man who has entrusted to you. Since the olden days, the sword has been used to fend off evil. Its blade is infused with the desire to become strong and righteousness. Be strong, my good friend. And now we got a sword. Which we could definitely, now we can like literally head into the forest anyway. And I may swap back into mod later after doing the intro stuff maybe. Which you're gonna see me a lot of, you're gonna see me doing it a lot throughout this playthrough because knowing that I don't even know how certain the game would crash with the mod. But for now, I'm just literally gonna have it for default Link. You can see my house happen there. All right, let's head in. Hello. I'll take one ruby, thank you.
Slow down.
Let me know for like any audio balancing.
Hi, Big Brother!
Yeah. And of course we need to go get a shield, which we'll have to go over here. Is this what you're looking for? Take it with you. You got the hero shield. This is a legendary shield said to be used by the hero himself. Poor grandma. Well, gotta go get her. Gotta get the little sister anyway. Oh geez, I drop a lot of frames. Holy shit. So anyway, the pirate ship. So anyway, we're gonna go find Nico around the ship. Hey, yo. Oh, well now. Ahoy there. Ahoy there, Scrabble. As of today, I am your superior, Nico. Now, I promise I'll go on easy on you. As you do as I say, okay? Right. Now, first off, you have to take a test with all the new pirates have to take. It's a bit of a doozy, so get ready. You watch yourself, I'm about to show you, real careful, so you can cram it into your, no doubt mushy swabble brain. First off, you gotta press the switch. It's only the easy part. Now check it out, after the platforms rise up from the floor, you gotta jump on them. Yeah! Okay, so I was able to jump to the first one myself, but this next one is too far, right? That's when you gotta do this. If you jump right on the rope, you can grab onto it and use the control stick left up and down as a swing. Swing until you get close enough to the next platform, and then press A to let go and then jump to it. So do you think you get how to do it? You have to swing it from platform to platform and try to get to the entrance from that room over there. Here's the problem though, Swabble. Platforms are only race for a little while, so if you don't get there by the time they drop, you have to start over. It will probably take you at least 1 year before you get good enough at make it all the way from here. One rough year, one tough year, full of bumps and bruises. Of course, if you manage to do it faster, I'll reward you. Now give it a try. This ought to be a good for a chuckle or two. As if, anyway. Ooh. And it came up this way. There we go.
What? You did it already?
I'm proud of you. So you have, I'm proud of you to have you as my underling.
I wonder if it's okay, to just give you that to him. I don't see why not. I doubt I'll get busted. Alright, Travel.
I'll tell you what. You can have the treasure in that chest over there. It's a reward from the great and generous Nico. Hurry and take it before someone comes. And with that, I get a bung. Good. You're gonna hear a lot of bungs every time I get to a chest. We got the spoils bag. You can keep the items you get from enemies from this handy pouch. You can hold up to 8 kinds of items. And press X, Y, or R on the item screen to see what's inside.
Hey, Jacob! We went to a Forsaken Fortress. Hurry up and get in here.
Alrighty. And we don't have to go back in here anyway because Christ.
Super Dave, this is Miss Tetris cabin. Most of us wheel pirates aren't even allowed in here. There's no way we're letting an outsider in. Don't even think about it, you know?
If I came in, I could definitely just show a screenshot of like pretty much the mod I was working on. This is the model I was working on, like pretty much. And literally, I can't able to get this working because due to a certain due to the fact that like the game just like just wants to do that anyway. Also, where is my goddamn where you gamepad screen? There you are. Why are you over there? Let me bring you over here. And just do this right here. And save the video game. And continue. So yeah, this is the mod I was working on. I was able to get it to work, but due to the fact that certain areas that I tried to enter, it just apparently wants to crash. I don't know why Simu just wants to crash. I don't know why it did that. But I will be testing this game I will be playing this game again on my off time for practice runs or practice doing a playthrough of this game. But yeah, I will double check and make sure how these areas work. But for now, we're going to be just sticking for this for now. Well, whatever. There's something you need to see. You have a look over there. That's the Cursed Isle I noticed, the Forsaken Fortress.
Sorry about that, Jerem. I had to mute my microphone because due to my coughs. Yeah, I've been I'm kind of a little sick because of my I'm having a lot of bad coughs as of late. I don't know why. It's just I may have to get a cough drop or something. Probably after the stream, or probably once I go on break, I'll probably get a cough drop or something. Yeah, just to. You know. Anyway, I'm not gonna be able to read a lot of this because due to my coughs anyway. But just to be fair, anyway. Yeah. See ya. Forsaken Fortress. Well, now we're gonna do the stealth mission. And I see OBS is being read. Alright. I'm gonna pick this up. And now we gotta go. Metal Gear. Colonel, have you ever been to Forsaken Fortress? I almost got caught. Nothing really going on in this room in this area. Nothing in here. Well, we'll have to come back to this area pretty much later. That's pretty much the thing about this game, that we'll have to come back to this area probably later. Anyway, we got these assholes right over here. Ooh, ooh. I wonder what's going on around these areas.
Shit!
And of course, a rat. A fucking rat! Literally just saw me! Motherfucker!
I'll take the yellow rupee though.
Time to catch.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that you always gotta crouch anyway because knowing that like in these areas, it's like, you know, you just gotta like have like one of those. It's like you gotta have one of those times like you have to do that anyway. Also, what's in this chest? A dungeon map, of fucking course. Actually, you know what? I could probably just say, you know what? I'm gonna size this up a bit more. No, I don't want to put it too much. That seems good enough. You know what? That seems good enough. It's like you can barely see it. You can barely see it if you're just playing it on that. Like if you're just watching it full screen, you can barely just hear it. Oh, I hate these enemies. Get the fuck away. No. Fuck off. I'm out of here. Fuck off. I don't want any of you. Fuck off!
Actually, you know what? Let me swap it to the Wii U Pro Controller. Let me switch to that method real quick. Give me a moment when I have to set this right here. I'm just gonna just do this. Oh, I need to turn this off, and then I need to go. I'm gonna go to the Wii U gamepad right here. Go to options. Go to here. Go to here. There we go. Switch to Pro Controller. There we go. And unfortunately, we can't literally use like literally the touch screen. But we can use the map still. Also, you know what? I'm gonna size the Wii U the gamepad view. I'm gonna size this up, and then I'll have to like shrink it down. I'm gonna do this, and then doesn't really matter. I think it matters to have the Ruby count. Let's just set it for there for now. At least I just have it bigger. And if it gets in the way, just let me know. If it gets in the way, I can just turn it off and just have it on my end. But yeah, I'm gonna have this right over here. So that way I can just knowing where the fuck am I even going in this map. But yeah, this stream is going to be a blow up for how many times it's going to drop frames. Jesus fucking Christ. Sora, thank you for the raid. How was your raid, my guy? Kingdom Hearts, goddamn it, my brain. I literally took a nap and literally Jesus fucking Christ. Does this stream smell like darkness to you? Well, kind of yes, actually. Hello, Sora. Hello, Blodia. Hello, Raid Smash. So how was the Wiikus anyway? Seven hours to beat Rico's story? Oof, my guy. I'm gonna just stay right here. It was a good time. Good to hear. But anyway, thank you, Sora, for the raid. And for those that came by, I was originally going to plan on getting a mod to work for Wind Waker.
Who there? Who there? Maybe it's just my imagination. It might be my imagination. That might be what it is.
Is it the Linkle mod? No. But I do plan on, I do have it installed, just for for like a backup reason.
But what I was going to do, initially, I was going to do this mod right here. I was going to do a recolor mod, just to represent myself anyway, to Link. Due to the fact that, yeah. Yeah, I was going to get this thing to work. Unfortunately, due to... It may crash. I don't know why it crashes the game. Like, when I enter, certain areas, I don't know why it does that. With that mod enabled. I just don't even know why it just crashed for CMU. Hey, if it works for Kirby, it works for Link, too. What game were you referring to? Are you thinking about Smash? Was it Smash Wii U, actually? Or are you just talking about, a Kirby game, specifically? Kirby and Amazing Mirror, actually. Okay. But yeah, I wish I could get this mod to work. I literally wish I can get this mod to fully work in-game. But just unfortunately, CMU just refused to run it. So I'll have to figure out and toy around with it a little more on my off time. But yeah, thank you, Sora, for the raid, and also the host. Yeah, this is why I if I was playing a Kingdom Hearts game, Jesus Christ, I am not going through every single fucking game of that. I am not gonna enjoy all the games of it. Especially Rechain of Memories. Cause that game is very gimmicky, and is especially known as a card game, as a gimmick. Now, can I actually... How do I actually get over there? Without being caught. Does it really matter? It does matter. Okay. Good to know, because Jesus fucking Christ. Now, how the hell do I actually get rid of our spotlights? How do I get rid of our searchlights? Jesus fucking Christ. Bank stream elements for doing what? I don't know why stream elements do that, but thank you. Why'd you do that? I don't know. I may have to turn off stream elements for that one. Oh yeah, every time when someone gets timed out or banned, mix it up and plays the gun sound just to make it more unique, because that's from the gun starts from Shadow the Hedgehog. I may have to turn them down, actually. You know what, let me go turn them down.
Oh yeah, no, check the chat room. chat. Edit command.
I'm gonna bring you back. I'm gonna bring you down to 50. You had to turn yourself down as well. Let me turn myself a little bit down. It's a good thing why I have to do a little bit of volume balancing because Jesus fucking Christ. No, sorry, it was a stream element, do that. I still need to keep on messing around with stream elements. Because I still have no idea how to get, like, I'm still working with that. It'd be funny sometimes, I don't know why it does that, but I get why, like being all gimmicky. I'm guessing the Autobahn bot, probably as well Siri bot. I don't know how they work. Don't you just hate it when an application changes at the audio level set when you tab out of it? Probably when you especially games that pause the audio when you tap alt tab out. Oh god damn it. You know what? Hey yo! Put me back in. Because of the fact that I fucked up my jump. Some games, especially older clients, do that. Yeah. That's the one thing I hate about when you do like audio balancing and stuff for it. I'll have to put it like a little chat overlay above my head. Probably some other time. I'll have to figure getting that out. I know Streamlabs does it, but I don't even know what other I don't even know if Stream Elements also do that or mix it up. I'll have to figure out somehow to do it. I'll have to figure out somehow to get it to work for the chat overlay. Anyway, let's try this again of climbing all the way back up. Like, I know this is not really completely pain. Like, this is literally, like, not completely bad. Like, I've done it before, but it's been, like, a hot minute at trying to figure out how this works. There's a rat over here. I want this rat. Just go the fuck away. Thank you. I'm gonna wait for this goblin. Just turn around. Look how goofy he is. You see how goofy he is? This dude right here. This is what I like about Zelda games. In general, like, they can be goofy at times. Especially in this game as well, Phantom Hourglass and Spirit Tracks. The designs of these enemies can be very goofy, and I love it. Like, especially this guy. Like, look at this guy. He's so goofy. Like, I love it. This is why this game is comic relief, anyway. Bringing that humor, you know? Of being cartoonic. Anyway, back to where I was originally at. Actually, what's over here, actually? What is down here? Aha! I see. Yep, maybe if it can drop its weapon, I can definitely, hit him, smack him around. Hey, give me the thing. Ow. Ow, bitch. There we go. Fucking A. Was there, like, another one I have to go back and go get? Yeah.
Yep. Son of a bitch.
This is gonna take me a bit, chat room. This is gonna take me a bit. Cause knowing that it's been a hot minute since I last played this game. Is yay solving puzzles? Solving puzzles of literally trying to figure where you fucking need to go. Because that is the most trend of Zelda games. Is figuring out where the fuck do you have to go. Yep. Son of a bitch. Get me back over there. At least it's not like punishing, at least it's not even like punishing, like literally by getting caught anyway. You're just literally just coming back here. And also I'm getting three rubies anyway from that jar, just respawning. Which is good. More money for me. More money for me. For a fucking moment, Link, please get onto the goddamn rope, you son of a bitch. Okay, I see what the game wants me to do. And of course I'm not gonna get any fucking hearts. Holy shit. Why am I not getting any goddamn hearts?
Ow. I'm pressing. You got a joy pendant. You can keep it on your spoils bag. Those pendants are sent to flock to those who spread joy like butterflies like nectar filled blossoms. Yay. I'd be afraid to drop down in a very high, in a very, very, very high height. God damn it. Hey, you. He's gonna come down over here, right? Yep.
hear any footsteps? That might be my imagination. Yeah, it might be my imagination anyway. Yeah, nothing around. Yeah, nothing around. What is that over there? I don't know what that is.
I've been thought about, I thought about having a few co-coms on stream. I thought about, having, like, a bit of few co-coms. Knowing that, my shenanigans, I would be down to have, more co-coms, on these regular streams, Like, I thought about that at some point in my mind. But yeah. Eh? Oh, I was doing combos. This is one thing why I played fucking Wind Waker. You could do combos on this shit. I don't know how, this version of Link, has combos. There he is, the man himself. Yeet! Yeah, you did startle me. I suppose that it's only natural. As wide as the world is, I'm the only boat upon that who could speak the words of men. I am the great. I am the king of red lions. Do not fear. I am not your enemy. I have been watching you since you went to the Forsaken Fortress to rescue your sister. I understand how you desire your.
I understand how your desire to protect your sister could give you the courage to really stand up to anything.
Well, the big ocean, hey, DG.
But such a bold attempt was foolhardy. I suppose you saw him, the shadow of that monstrous bird. His name is Gaddon.
How are you? I'm doing good, DG. I just woke up from a nap and literally, you know what? We're just gonna play some Wind Waker because since today is Wednesday, this game's gonna be for Wednesday slot. Since we finished Shadow, I did promise I'd play Wind Waker. Hope the nap was good. I took a small nap, but I've been working on a lot of this actually. I was trying to get this thing to work. However, it starts to crash. I don't know why it fucking crashed for some fucking reason in certain areas in the game. I don't know why it does that. But I'll have to tweak around a bit more of it and see how that does. You'll figure it out eventually. Yeah, I'll figure out eventually for it. I'll just have to like literally figure out of eventually how to get that thing to more work. It just like I really need to find someone who knows who mods this game, like no more knowledge, which I'll have to post. I'll post it on Twitter about it and see if somebody can give me an answer of why that happens. I might just do that sometime later. Not today though, but maybe sometime like some other day. Yeah. So anyway, now we're into basically Windfall Island. Which we're gonna come back here pretty much quite amount a few times.
Oh, if you please, young boy, Vanner, please help me.
Please listen to my tale of woe. Okay.
Ho-ho, my sweet, sweet daughter. My only daughter, poor Maggie. She was captured by a bunch of villains and taken to the Forsaken Fortress.
I still have Steam UI, but I should get this working eventually. I somehow really want to try out this game compared to the other Zelda.
Yeah.
What on earth do those scoundrels want with her? Are they just roaming around looking for young maidens? Are they just evil creatures that delight in mischief?
Well, crud! Having a kidnapped daughter doesn't get you a single ruby, you know? Please save my daughter. I beg of you. Here I stand, begging.
I hope you'll give those scoundrels in Forsaken Fortress a good scare.
They'll pay for what they've done. Oh yes, pay!
I don't know, it just really seems really darn charming. I'm down there for more charming games. Yeah, this game is really charming.
absolutely fucking charming. And funny enough, since I'm like, I had this here. Do I have it locked in? Okay, no, I don't, but I can just do this anyway. So what's interesting about this game, I know Twilight Princess also has this for the HD version, because you could definitely like have this map right here, which is basically that anyway. I don't have a, I used to have a, I'm not using the Wii U gamepad mode because I'm using the Wii U Pro Controller mode right now. It's because convenience sake. That's better. Let me open up you. But yeah, this game, like, this is the one thing I appreciate for the gamepad, screen, that you can literally just have it as your map screen anyway, of navigating where to go. All right, let's see. Where do I get a sail? Where do I get a sail? Where do I get a sail, mateys? I'll have to find a sail. Do you value teeth? Because I know someone who will. These kids, probably. Yeah. All right, I'm trying to remember, where do you go from here? Oh wait, I have to go. I know. Now I remember. Now I remember where you need to go now. My brain just literally just like, I literally just sparked a bulb of where you need to go. You gotta go to here. So who's ready to meet the best character of all time? Tingle. What's up, Tingle? Same green clothes and the same green hat. By the luck of you, I say, sir, could you by chance be a fairy? Goodness. Pain. Visual pain. Goodness, sir, did you feel my telepathy? That's why you saved me, isn't it? Isn't it? Do not worry, Tingle knows that without you telling him, sir. Yes, sir. I probably don't need to know why he's in jail. I don't know why. I don't know either why is he in jail. I don't know why. Damn, this guy, on the two Japanese only DS games that got a Zelda cameo? Damn, what?
What an honor. Yep, this guy right here, Tingo is my name. I've been looking for you and your kind, for I, too, long to be one of the fairy folk. And yet I was mistaken for some kind of troublemaker and put into this dreadful sort of place.
How disrespectful!
Please, Mr. Fairy, rescue poor Tingle from this place and take him to where you and your kind live to splendor. Let me do it again. If you help me, I'll give you a fabulous present. So, please, Mr. Fairy, please rescue poor Tingle and take him to where you and your kind live in harmony. Alright, I gotta figure out how to get him out of here. Thankfully, this isn't as bad for photorealistic Tingle that used in Hyrule Warriors. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I remember the Hyrule Warriors design for Tingle. Jesus fucking Christ, that guy.
Oh.
No, that's not it. That's just not it. And the problem is, even though that's not it, this isn't it either. Oh dear, pardon me, guy. I was so fully and woolly absorbed into my dance thing that I didn't even notice a little old you standing there. My name is Tot. I love dancing more than I love it. I love three meals a day. You will come to know me as the world charismatic dancer extraordinaire. Okay. Okay, I need to talk to the King of Red Lions again, to do what I'm supposed to do here. Find a sail. Finding a sail. Where do I find a fucking sail? It's not in here, pretty much. No. There's gotta be one shop in here that may sell one. Is it this right here? Okay. Alright, I gotta figure the fuck out of where the fuck do I have to do here. It's been a hot minute since I'm trying to figure out what the fuck I'm trying to do here. Because now I know where Tingle is. Aha! The switch.
Hooray! Thank you! Oh, so very much!
Here's the Tingle's heartfelt gift of thanks.
Tingle! Tingle! Kooloo Supply!
Become an item! And now you got the Tingle bottle! Using me first, you can insert a message. Basically, it's there for like for using Miiverse, even though Miiverse is already fucking dead, so we're not gonna be able to use this. Satellite, we're just not gonna be able to do it. Because due to the fact the service is already shut down anyway. It's So you won't be able to use the tingle bottle anyway. But we do get a tingle shard. You can now send letters in tinkle bottles by using Miiverse. Don't receive even. Because it's already just like literally just nope. Oh yeah, I also need to change it back to the map. There we go. So yeah, this is like one of the things about this game that or pretty much what's updated to this game, that back in the GameCube day, you had to hook up a connector from the GBA to the GameCube. There was a little connector you had to do with it. I can't show it off, but I have to get Dolph. I had to go all the way back to where to this point to where Dolph to the original Wind Waker is. But yeah. Aha. So there's like traps that. I see. All right, let's go back in there. Grab a blue whoopie anyway. I think this is where I came through. Aha. Of course, I'm not a mouse. Alright, let me look up a map guide for this one. Which is, of course, you're gonna see me like pretty much. I have to bring up a lot of guys. I have to bring up a few guides for this one. Windfall Island. Map. Thank you. I got the Mesa map up on my up to where my screen is, so that way I can see where the fuck I need to go. I need to bring chat back in here, so that way I can just like monitoring it. Okay. Let's go back to where we are doing this the third time in a row. Because now just I'm using a guide just only for now. Even though I will be at figuring out the rest of it at my own. All right, let's grab this. And we got the Picto Box. All right, get me out of here. With the Picto Box, we're pretty much now can do basically to do photos. Rubies, nah. Eighty rubies, fine. I had enough anyway. Anyway, we got the boat sail, right? So that's literally what we had to come back for to talk to this dude. Because we had like literally ran into him before we rescuing Tingle.
We'll have to come back here some other time in order to get the other sail.
Thank you.
All right. So basically now it wants us to go over here, this direction. And this is why we set sail in a brand new adventure. That's what the stream title is literally says, because we are going in on a new adventure to set sail in the seas. In the great sea. And I figured this is also a good, perfect time to pick this game up for the summertime. Because no one is fucking hot in the summertime. Because it really hit like 101 degrees, like a few hours, like a couple hours ago. Like when it was still daytime, for me personally. There, on the horizon. That's our destination, Jacob. Dragon Roost Island. All right, you know what? I'll turn the bitrate like a little bit down. About 4. I'll turn it down to 4 and see how that works. And now we got the Wind Waker. Get it? Wind Waker, literally, it's literally the title of the game. For Zelda. The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. By using this magical constructor's baton, you can borrow the power of a gods. Press the right stick to conduct. Don't tell the left stick to conduct 3 to 4 time. Hold the... Left stick left for the 4x4 time and hold the left stick to the right to conduct 6x4 time. Yay.
And now we learn that when's Wekium? Yep, that's one. That's a mighty nice breeze. My name's Zephyros. I am the god of winds. So you're the new Wind Waker, are you? Great, great. For a beginner, you're got a nice wind season. Nice wind sense about you. I like you, kid. That tone you just pick up? Well, it gives you a control over the direction that wind blows. Depending on how you use it, wind can be a good thing or a bad thing. You want an example of it being a bad thing? Then you should see my brother. It's saddened to say that my brother, Silos, it's myth about his movement here. Being broken. Now he spends his time creating cyclones to torment people with. If you encounter any cyclones at sea, try to always have my brother for me, will you? And that is my quest for you. So long! And there he goes in the far distance. Jeez, I am dropping a lot of things today. Which is pretty much not affecting the stream from what I can see and tell. And it's probably not affecting any of you guys. Okay. Oh, I need to climb up here. Let me do this. Probably when I get to the first, once I get to the dungeon here, because we're about to be close to the first dungeon of the game. The very first main dungeon in the game. And then we'll pretty much just call it there. Because we're going to be going through a lot of intro stuff. For like the first 2 hours of the game. Oh shit.
Oh, hey. I've seen you before.
Jesus fucking Christ, I almost like jump off.
Yeah, I'm still getting tired anyway. It's just that I still haven't got enough sleep.
But yeah, I'll call it once I'm finished here. Which is gonna be very, very, very quickly soon. Yep, the dragon on top, yep.
Ah, we got the delivery bag. With so many pockets that it can hold as many items, eh? You will find Medlia in one of the upper rooms. Leave the great Valu to us. In the meanwhile, do your best to eat at Prince Kamali.
Hello.
Ah, you accepted father's letter. This is a letter from father addressed to his son. And now we have the delivery back. Yeah, we can definitely send it out to the prince. And we'll talk to her some other time later. You there. Alright, bitch. Absolute fucking asshole. Huh. Din's Pearl. Alright, so now we gotta go all the way back up, upstairs. Sorry for the moment of silence, here because, Jesus, my brain is starting to turn off. Trying to figure out where do you go from here. Do you have to go from here? No, but that's for later. This is the part. Thank you. Oh, it's literally,
Never.
Oh, thanks. Pour some water into where I'm gonna pour some water to a bomb. Yep. We're gonna plant a bomb. Dragon Roost Cavern. Alright. As much as I like to go on, this is kind of a, all of a sudden a very short stream. I normally stream like pretty much like 6 p.m. to 11 p.m. anyway, but this is going to be kind of a short stream. But we'll be back here next week for more Ocarina of... Why did I say Ocarina of Time? Why is my head... Like, this is not Ocarina of Time. This is Wind Waker. Next time on Wind Waker, we'll be going into Dragon Roost Cavern. Yeah, this, like, I'm really, I did not get enough sleep, pretty much today. Like, holy fucking shit, I did not get enough sleep. Yeah, I'm gonna go get some sleep and hibernate. And yeah, thank y'all for watching anyway. Thank you, Sora, for the raid of, with the number of, how many viewers was it? With a rate of 5, but yeah, thank you, Sora, for the raid, and thank you all for coming by, Bloodia, DG, Sora, who else came by here? Raid Smash as well. And yeah, let's go find a raid target. I'm gonna go get some sleep because I'm gonna go piss the fuck out. I'm also gonna save as well. You know what? There we go. Who is live tonight? Who is actually live tonight? Actually, I have not raided this person before. So, we're gonna go to Dream Trove. I'm gonna look to let. All right. Slash raid dream Rove. She is doing some art. You gotta love some art, apparently. I don't even know if she's ending her stream. I don't even know how long she's been going at. She's been streaming for like about 6 to 7 hours. Probably about 6 hours or so. But yeah, let's go raid Dream Trove. She's doing some ort. And for the raid matches, we're going to have... Fuck, what's a good raid message? Fuck. What's a good raid message? There's so many good moments out there. There were so many good moments. What is a good raid message? Honestly, I can't think of anything. Just say literally push your favorite emote. You know what? Just post your favorite emote. You know what? Just post your favorite emote, or just literally just give her a smile. You know what? Just say, you know, just give her a smile. Right? So yeah, that's probably the main message. I can't think of it. I'll think of something. The next time we play this game, I'll think of something. I'll think of something about that. But anyway. Thank y'all for watching. I'll see you guys on Thursday for probably Doom. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye-bye.